Using hand tools seems to be all the rage these days. I'm not particularly into using hand tools, but I thought I'd show you some of my favorite hand planes and how they differ from the usual hand planes that people look for. So I'll start with this plane. It's a jointure plane that I picked up at a yard sale. So this is a jointure plane. What's unusual compared to your typical Lie Nielson plane these days is it's a very simple plane. The sides of it are just a raw casting. This wasn't even machined. And if you look on here, the little adjustment wheel, that's actually just made out of stamped sheet metal. And if we take it apart a little bit, take the blade out, not a very thick blade, but it's okay. And then looking in here, the frog of it, the part that actually holds the blade, is just made out of stamped sheet metal. So this plane was from the very beginning made to be a very cheap hand plane. And they just don't make them like this anymore because people who buy hand planes these days often have a bit of a tool fetish and they want something that's really well made, although expensive. This plane was probably bought by a workman just to use as a plane probably 40 years ago. So even though this plane is a very cheaply made plane, it planes very nicely. So this is just some shavings I did off some oak, which is much harder to plane than the usual softwoods people usually show off planes with. Another favorite hand plane is this one. What's unique about this one is it's very light, and usually you want your hand plane to be nice and heavy, but a light plane is very handy if you have to take it somewhere in your luggage. So I've actually had this plane with me visiting my sister a few times because I can just put it in my suitcase and it doesn't add too much weight. An interesting about this plane is the way the blade is adjusted is there's these two screws to adjust the left and right side individually instead of having this long lever and adjustment knob. So you have to adjust one side at a time like you would on a spokeshave, but it works okay and it's a nice little plane. And it does a decent job planing the oak, so can't complain about this plane. And finally, this little plane is my most used plane in the whole workshop. I don't so much use it for planing, but it's a great little plane for just rounding or beveling the edges of pieces of stock. So the square edges on a piece of wood after cutting or planing are actually quite sharp. And before I can turn this into a piece that's nice to handle, those need to be rounded some ways. Now I could round those with sandpaper or with a router, but the quickest way is just to use a little hand plane like this, take a few passes at different angles, and that puts a nice little round on it. You can hardly see it, but it really feels different. And I can even use it to handle the edges on the end just by going over like this. And I'll do the corners too like this. If I want those to be a little bit rounder, I'll then sand it, but it's easier to remove the bulk of the material with a plane because I don't like sanding. It's dusty and it's work. So I like to think of some of these hand planes as sort of the anti-Lie Nielson hand planes because they're pretty much the opposite of what Lie Nielson prides themselves for with their hand planes. But I really like these planes and I don't have any Lie Nielson planes, so good enough for me.